All right, guys, Elite Hacker here, voice of the joining me, I have.
Elite Plant.
Elite Sharp.
All right, so basically I just have a few questions for these guys. Plant, it hasn't been too long since I last interviewed you. Has anything else?
Yeah, we got some expanding in the organization. I mean, and a little bit of, I guess... Somebody decided to switch teams. You know, he wasn't feeling the flow, which I can understand. So we're now actually going to be sending two teams over to Vegas.
So that kind of split up the skill set of everyone, or is he just making a completely different team?
He'll be making a different team, but it's still going to, like, mess with the skill set and the skill of mine. Like, the way that Sharp plays is completely different than the way that Maui plays. We like to call him Maui. But it, I mean, like, I don't think they could be on a team together, and neither does Sharp, I don't think.
Oh, no, honestly, we have different play styles, and it's not even the play styles. It's we have different views as to how we want to use our time and how we want to practice. So there's a lot of teams you'll see, a lot of teams that are professionals are teams that take it to another level. They take the studying of the game, they take the intricacy of the game, and they study it, and they take it, I mean, like I said, to another level. And that's what separates all of the pros from us amateurs. And I feel like I'm not at all saying that one of us has a professional idealism and the other has an amateur idealism. We both have perfectly fine ways of going about it. We just have ways that aren't going to clash together.
All right. So with this whole entire splitting, do you think that you guys are prepared for the upcoming competition, or do you guys still have some work to do?
I mean, obviously the game's not even released yet, so anybody with a roster still isn't ready. So, I mean, we have like, give or take, 8 days on the game. We'll play the Battle Royale beta in the next 2 weeks, and that'll be a good time. But as far as, I think everybody's going in on a level playing field. I think we're all going to be prepared, but obviously, you know, I'm very confident in myself, and I'm very confident in my team and my organization, so there's no reason for me to say otherwise.
Anything to add on that plan?
You know, I'm actually on the same page with him. I'm very confident that this team will succeed. I'm also confident that Impact will succeed. You know, both they are very well, like, played teams. I've played with Mally. I've played with Sharp. You know, the way that Sharp, you know, like, explains to me, like, everything that we need to do, like, I definitely love his ideas, and I think it's great ideas, and we definitely need to be doing that way more often. And the way that Mally's going to be playing is, you know, just, I don't know, but he's definitely a Calvary out there, so I just want to see how he does that, but I'm confident in them as well.
So, last time we talked, we got on the red line situation. Has anything changed in that, or Sharp, if we could get you open?
Alright, well, give me just a second here. Okay, so the red line situation is actually more or less the reason I'm in this organization. It sort of was a thing where I have idealisms very close and very similar to that of Kobe here, and when I saw what was going on from a player perspective, coming out, someone who's been urging to coming out of retirement and having finding that reason to come out of retirement for this game, I found it, and I'm gonna send you the DMs. The first DM that I had sent Kobe as soon as they started getting heated in my mentions, but it was a very good time. Let's just say that. My view of it, I think the kid's totally wrong. He acted immaturely, he acted hastily, and he acted with quite honestly the strongest ego I've ever seen in a player.
Blaine, do you have anything to add to that, or do you wrap it up pretty good?
He did really wrap that up. But this dude definitely, I mean, I've played with him once, when I was recruiting him myself. And you know what, like, kid is pretty good, but he's thinking highly of himself. And it's way too high of himself. And I mean, if he's thinking way too highly of himself, one, like, that's not going to help cut out for the team. That's not going to help the team in any way, shape, or form. Anybody, like, even if, I mean, you've been playing for years at it and you're good, like, that cocky attitude is not going to help anybody out. And two, like, for the new players, I've mentioned it in the last interview, and, you know, it's just a thing of, like, it's definitely not going to help them out any way, shape, or form, because they're not going to want to, like, succeed.
All right. So we got on the Vegas, but is there anything else you guys kind of, like, see in the future of the organization at any point, or?
We're working on a lot of current behind-the-scenes developments that aren't necessarily things that can be released publicly at the moment, but we have a lot of exciting things planned, and we have a lot of things in motion for the organization that we think everyone's going to love.
Took the words out of my mouth.
Playing?
But also, to add on to that, you will not see a lot of tweets about Elite Forces squad. You won't see a lot of tweets about the Elite Impact squad. You won't, I mean, I'm not gonna let this happen. I'm not gonna let anybody know what's going on, because just for the fact of, I want them to be focused on, you know, recruiting, well, not recruiting, but playing, practicing, doing whatever they can to be better and, like, definitely beat this kid if he actually shows up to Vegas.
We're hoping he does. We're really hoping he does.
Because if you read the tweet that Sharpie just took
the
a screenshot. Yeah, the DMs. If you read that, that pretty much
pretty
explains
much,
it all.
Yeah, it pretty much speaks for itself.
You can read out a lot if you want. That's perfect fine with me.
I mean, all right, so it started as soon as I saw Redline hop into my mentions, taking shots at Elite Forces and at Kobe personally, I got offended. So I hopped into Kobe's DMs, and he texts me. He goes, "What's up, man?" I said, "I want to beat the blank out of that kid. I want to play for you just for that reason." That is all. Like, there's a fire that lit a flame in me that hasn't been lit since Call of Duty Ghosts.
Sounds like you guys are pretty fired up about this competition.
If this kid does not show up, I will honestly take this as a failure.
It will also
whether,
be a waste
whether
of
he
my
shows
money.
Up, whether he shows up as a player or as a coach, I don't care. I'm going to beat the living hell out of this team. Single-handedly, if I have to.
I don't think he's going to show up as a coach.
I hope he does show up as a player, because then I can actually destroy him.
This dude is literally, like, I don't think he's done any sort of recruiting, personally. I don't think he's done anything in that nature, which, I mean, it's kind of hard to recruit people for Black Ops 4 when you're in World War II, but, you know, when we go out into, like, Vegas, it's going to be a different story. Like, right now is the time to get your team and get them, like, you want your team pretty much just, like, close together, I'd say. And that's exactly what I want with Elite Forces, and that's what I'm working for, is for us to get close together, be, like, best friends, because Sharpie told me a story about MLG Vegas, not in it, Vegas, but in an MLG event, FaZe lost to a group of friends. Like, if we recruit in World War II, know that they're going to get Black Ops 4, we become best friends, we're close to each other, so we can actually, like, be able to communicate with each other, or actually not even have to communicate, like telepathically tell each other what to do. Like,
yeah, you know, it sort of becomes Call of Duty teams. You can watch, like, you've seen Optic, for example, is a perfect one. Like, they're a brotherhood. They're not a team. Like, once you're a part of Optic, like, you're a part of that legacy. And you're, I mean, granted, it is the brand that's behind it, but the story that he's referring to, anybody can go look this up. It was at Call of Duty Champs 2014. It was Advanced Warfare. So, FaZe, it was Sunday, Championship Sunday. Optic had been eliminated, I believe. FaZe was playing TR. The roster was Aqua, Facento, I don't remember the other two. But anyways, it was FaZe when Clayster was playing for him, I'm pretty sure. It was Clayster, Attach, Zuma maybe, and somebody else. And this team had been best friends for a year or so going into this event, had never competed at another event. And they had just played online and, you know, gotten their shit together, became best friends. They go to this event and they play second. I don't know how a team can go online, just a bunch of real life friends, go to an event and win, almost win at the very least, against literally all odds at Call of Duty Champs, the toughest tournament of the year. And I don't know. So that's, since I saw that, my philosophy behind building a team and building a roster has always been, you can put any four players together. If you guys are the best of friends, you'll find a way.
And so think about it this way too. Like,
you gotta
like,
play.
They made it out of pool play too. Like, they went into pool play, made it out of pool play, and then got onto stage.
Yeah. Open. Well, yeah, they had to go through pool play. Yeah, that's right.
So that's a lot of games in one day, or 3 days.
5 days.
5 days.
5 days. 5 days.
5 days.
Similar to what happened with this past event when Optic got eliminated.
So I find it almost like Redline's getting a little bit of a taste of his own medicine with what you guys are saying, like how he's having recruiting people, but this whole entire problem occurred was against recruiting people. So it's almost like he has to go back on his word and go back on what he said so he could just make a team.
If he does.
Yeah, that. Essentially. To my understanding, the original argument started off of him claiming that Kobe does not know how to build a team or find solid players. I believe that is how the argument and all of this sparked. I may be wrong.
And let's think about it real quick. I found a solid player on Twitter because of him. Thank you.
Yeah, because of him. He didn't even need to. Yeah, and he didn't even look for me. I kind of found him.
He had messaged me, I don't think this org is right for me, I'm out. I said, you do you. I'm a 17-year-old leader. Like, I have to deal with my schooling and players' health and try to recruit loyal players. I specifically had loyal in caps. And then he responded, like, with that. As with that response, you have no business running an org. So, apparently he doesn't know how to run a team.
From that, I would take off of that his philosophy on how to build a team is business first. I see it the same way, but it's business will override personal decisions in all situations. It just will in this industry. And people don't necessarily understand that, and that's what causes a lot of teams, like, it causes their fate, honestly.
Well, I'm going to have to see in the upcoming competition about his team-building skills, and at the end of my interviews, I always like to ask if you guys would like to add anything else that I didn't ask about, or anything coming up, or anything that you guys just want.
No, on that note, really, we're going to be keeping a lot of the behind-the-scenes things behind the scenes. We're not going to be leaking a whole lot about it. We will definitely be teasing the shit out of everybody, so be ready for that. There is going to be some fresh new looks coming to the entire organization soon. I'd like to tease that.
Seasonal. That's all I'll say from that.
All right.
But you know, we also have like these players out here. I mean, like, let's put Blue in it for an example. You know, he's right now. He hopped on a different account. Got a 0.56 KD. You know, sent that in. Wanted to know if that was good. But now he's going out and playing more. And you know, like me and Sharp had this conversation. KD doesn't matter.
I would like to, before we even go any further on Hunter, I would like to just touch on the fact that communicating with him is such an issue for the last few days because of his headset situation, and that has put a big taint on what we've been trying to do.
Yeah.
And it's definitely put his development back a little bit as far as we go as developing as a team.
But yeah. Once he gets his headset, we'll be all good.
Once he gets his headset and we can communicate properly and get him onto the same page, I feel like everything should fall into place.
All right. Well, sounds like you guys got a good plan, and I wish you guys the best of luck in the competition coming up. And this has been Elite Hacker, the voice of the org, joined by Plain and Sharp, and signing off.
See you guys. Peace.